Hello guys, welcome to my channel. In this video we are going to learn about the cooling pond and cooling tower. It will be in two videos. The first video will be of the cooling pond and the next video, which will be provided in the link, will be of the cooling tower. So first we are going to start about the cooling pond. It is a simple diagram of a cooling pond which can show us its working. The hot water is coming out of the refrigeration plant as it absorbs the heat from the refrigerant, and it is flown through the passage, and through the nozzle it is sprayed and broken into small particles so that the evaporation process takes place through the large amount of the surface area, and the cold water can be collected at the bottom of the reservoir, and the cold water is again recirculated to the refrigeration plant, which can be used for the condenser. It is a simple principle. The types of cooling pond are the single and double deck system and the natural and directed float system type. The first is the single spray pond. The single spray pond and the double deck spray pond diagram are present here. As you can see, the only difference here is of the nozzle. The height of the nozzle in a single spray pond is same throughout, but in a double deck spray pond the height of one type of nozzle is bigger than the other type of nozzle. There are two different heights of the nozzle. Rest the working is same as that I have explained of the pond. The hot water comes in and is sprayed throughout, and the cold water is collected from the bottom of the pond. And the other type is the natural flow cooling pond and the directed flow cooling pond. In the natural flow cooling pond, water is sprayed as in a natural way, and water is collected from the bottom, and no passage is given for the water to flow. It is just because of the natural convection and nothing else. But in the directed flow cooling system, direction is provided by using the baffles. Here we can see the partitions, which is known as baffles. As the hot water flows inside, the baffles will give a direction to the water, and the water will flow accordingly, and at last we can see that the water is poured out through the to the condenser, the cold water we can get from the outlet. Hope you learned from this video, and to watch the video of cooling tower, please click on the link below. Thank you.